Ahoj, this is Zdenka. Do you own an Android phone? Samsung, perhaps? I'm sure that for everyday filming, you are using just automatic mode to take photos and videos. But if you want to film in 24 frames per second, you might have to use third-party app like Filmic Pro or ProTake. Or you can take advantage of built-in feature in Android Pro Video Mode. It's a tutorial today. Let me go through all the settings, all the features step by step, and also show some practical examples. But first, I need to tell you that this video has been brought to you by Skillshare, which is an online community with thousands of great classes for creators. Why filming in manual mode? Well, filming in automatic mode is so easy. I just press the record button and I'm done. Well, here is a video filmed in automatic mode, and here is a video filmed in manual. What I'm able to do is film in 24 frames per second, control shutter speed, get that sweet motion blur, the natural motion rule, and control white balance as well, and focus. Where do we find Pro Video Mode? Let's go to More. And here we have Pro Video. As you can see, there are many settings and icons on both sides. Let's start with the left side. The first icon on the top left corner would be histogram. Here you can see if your video is overexposed or underexposed. Too many lines to the left means it's way too dark, underexposed. Too many lines on the right means overexposed. Ideal would be seeing this type of wave in the center, which means no blacks or whites are clipped. Below we have autofocus selection. You can choose from center or multi. Center means that the camera is focusing in the center of the frame. Wherever you point with your camera, the center will be sharp. This is good for when you are filming a place, landscape, city, large scenes. When you switch to multi, you will see that there are many different squares flickering on the screen. The camera is looking for a focus on the most contrasty object closest to the center. This would be great for filming a moving object, a person walking in the center of the frame, for example. If you want to lock autofocus exposure on the screen, you can tap on the object in a frame. To lock it, press and hold until yellow icon shows up. What that means that the video is not going to go lighter and darker wherever you point, and also the object will be sharp. It is not going to change focus on you. This is how you would be filming in automatic mode. Below is our frame rates and resolution. You have a choice to film in 24, 30, and 60 frames per second. UHD means 4K, FHD means 1080p, and HD means 720p. To get the best quality, select UHD and choose your desired frame rate. 24 will be cinematic, 30 more of a TV look, and 60 will give you a slow motion look. Ratio icon is next. You have a choice to film in full screen, 1:1 ratio, the Instagram look, 21:9, which is the wide cinematic look, or standard 16:9 video size. Next we have light. As default, it will be off. If you happen to film in a dark environment, you can choose to have it always on, but that will drain your battery faster, or select auto. The light will turn on when the camera feels that you need it. The best to keep it off and only turn it on when necessary. Let's go to settings and let's scroll to video section. Here we have advanced recording options where you can choose if you want to record high efficiency videos, which will save your space on your smartphone as it will save in HEVC format. However, you might not be able to play the videos on other devices or share them online. You can also select HDR 10 Plus videos, which will optimize contrast and color of each scene if you record with a rear camera and if you plan to post it, for example, on YouTube, which supports this feature and will play the video correctly. To be honest, I don't use any of these. Let's return to camera settings. Video stabilization is checked, which will help stabilize your video a bit. Below you can turn on tracking autofocus feature. What it means is that you can select an object and lock the focus on them as they move. The focus will keep moving with the object. However, when you turn that on, the video stabilization will turn off. Grid lines will help you with composition of the shot, so it is a good idea to turn that on. You will see those lines showing up on the screen. Instead of always having the object in the center of the frame, you can place them in the spots where the lines cross. This will also help you to make sure horizon level is perfect. Another great feature which can help you is going to shooting methods, where you can turn on voice comments. Instead of pressing the record button on the screen and introducing possible shake to the beginning of the video, you can just say record video and it will start automatically recording. Let's leave the settings and check out the right side of the app. When you select this, you can zoom in or zoom out. Unfortunately, this is only digital zoom, meaning that the more you zoom in, the more you will degrade the quality of the video. One thing which this app is missing is able to film with multiple lenses. This phone has a great ultra-wide angle lens and telephoto, however, it is set to standard lens. If you want to film manually with multiple lenses, Filmic Pro or ProTake app would be the way to go. If you have only one lens on your phone, this app is perfect for you. Below is a gray icon called Standard. It is not available because my file is UHD. You cannot use this feature in 4K. It is available if you film in 1080p, which is full HD. You can change the color profile in this setting, meaning that you can lower the contrast, highlights, bring shadows up, turn down or up saturation, change tint and temperature. If you want to go back to standard color profile, just scroll to the bottom where you see reset. Hit that and now you are in standard color profile. White balance is next. When you leave it in auto and move around wherever you are going to point with the camera, the number will change and also the white balance. The video will change colors on its own. It will be quite colorful. The best would be to change it to manual. This way, the white balance is locked and when you point, it will always stay the same. If you scroll up, the yellower it is going to get. If you go down, the more blue it will get. When you scroll to 5500K, you will see a sun icon. That means this is midday sun color. 6500K is cloudy, overcast. Autofocus icon is next. This is your focus. Right now, it is in autofocus mode. You can tap to select manual focus. Whenever you scroll up and down, you will see green color on the screen, which is focus peaking. This helps you to see what is in the focus, what is sharp. When you let go, the color disappears. Next is exposure compensation. Let's say I selected my focus by tapping on the screen and I locked it, but the video is still too bright. I want to darken it a bit. Well, I can do it right there. I will press the exposure compensation and drag it down until I'm happy with the shot. I'm finding that all phones are keeping the video quite bright. I like to bring it down a bit, always. Shutter speed is next. Here's where you can reach the natural motion blur in your video for a more pleasing look. Because it is automatic right now, the number changes all the time. The brighter it is, the higher the shutter speed is. There is no motion blur. If you are filming at 24 frames per second, you want to double the shutter speed. That is, select 1/50th of a second shutter speed. If you film in 30 frames per second, you will select 1/60th. And if you film in 60 frames per second, you will select 1/125th. Now, if you film in 24 frames per second and you have selected 1/50th, you will be fine indoors as it is quite dark. However, if you film outdoors, you will need to put sunglasses on the camera, which would be this variable ND filter. I'm using Moment phone case and filter adapter to attach that. I'm going to link it below the video for those interested. You will just turn the variable ND filter to darken it until it is perfect. Below we have ISO, which is light sensitivity of camera's sensor. If you film during bright day, you leave it in the lowest one, which is 50. If you film indoors or at night, you will have to increase the ISO to get more light in. You don't want to get too high though, as it will introduce noise in the video. Lastly, below we have sound settings, which is set to Omni. This captures sound in all directions. So you can see the sound in the panel on the left. By default, it is set to zero. If you want to increase the sound, you go up. If it is way too loud, you will bring it down. However, careful when you bring the sound up, you don't want that to be all jumpy all the way up. Way too strong and not pleasant. Here you can control the sound if you would be using a wired microphone or Bluetooth microphone. If you are enjoying this tutorial, then you might be also enjoying more classes at Skillshare. There are always new premium classes being launched. There are no ads as it is specifically curated for learning. It's quite affordable with annual membership, which is less than $10 a month. You can learn anything about illustration, graphic design, photography, animation, fine art, marketing, and much more. I personally really like Cinematography Basics, Understanding Filmmaking Style by Zach Mulligan, where he takes you on your process of creating proper cinema scene. He will show you how to prepare a shot list, and he breaks down the scene with this shot list. Skillshare is offering free trial to first 1,000 of my subscribers. You can find the link in the video description below so you can explore your creativity. All right, practical example. I'm in a studio, I have a controlled lighting, and I want to set up everything manually, so how do I do that? First of all, I'm filming in 24 frames per second, which is the Ultra HD 4K, and next step would be setting up the proper shutter speed. So I'm going to go from auto to manual, and here it has to double, so it has to be 1/50th of a second. Next, I'm going to go to ISO and adjust that accordingly. I'm gonna be looking at the histogram so it's not too much in the black, it's not clipping the blacks right about here. And let's go play with the focus a little bit. So I'm gonna go from auto and select the part I want to see. There, and now we are all set. I do have already ND filter ready on the camera, so if I'm filming in 24 frames per second, first I'm going to bring the ISO lower to 50. Next, I will adjust the shutter speed, which will be 1/50th of a second. And I can see that I can make it a little bit brighter, so I'm going to ease up a little bit with the ND filter. Next will be selecting the correct white balance, so I'm going to go for the day. Which is sunny, 5500K. And that will be it. If I wanted to film in manual focus, I will be adjusting the focus, but right now I'm quite happy as it is. I'm gonna leave it. And now because I'm filming in 60 frames per second, I have to change the shutter speed, which will be 1/125th. And because the ND filter is quite dark, I have to ease up on that. That's it, to get it quite in the middle. And now all I have to do is just record.
I hope this video helped you to understand how to film in Pro Video Mode on Android. Hit the thumbs up if it did and subscribe to future videos like these. If you have any questions, comments, or simply want to say hi or ahoy, you can always leave it below in a comment section. And I'll see you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao. Ahoy.